What's up, YouTube? Coach B here for some more Double Wing content. Before I get into what the main video is about today, I hope you guys enjoyed the the intro video. If you like my videos, man, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. Comment, man, drop your information, where you coach, whatever. I'm always interested in building my page and helping out coaches across the country. So as you saw from the intro video today, I'm going to be doing a just kind of an informational video on the play, which is not really a play, which is called Ray No Play. So a little bit of history about where I got Ray No Play from. All compliments go out to Steve Colande because this was part of his system. When I first started learning the double wing, I reached out to a bunch of coaches. This was kind of before YouTube and a lot of video on Teams was just commonly available like it is today. But back in the day, I kind of reached out to a bunch of coaches, Coach Wyatt, Coach Colande. I was dabbling, watching a little bit of Coach Murphy stuff. Jerry Vallotton's book, The Toss, is really good. So I went out and grabbed that and read it cover to cover a couple of times. And I settled on Steve Colande's system just simply because it was real easy for the kids to understand. I like the play calling specifically. Like the way he calls plays just really appealed to me. It was super simple. Ray and Lee motion. It was a lot of repetitive play calling. And I saw a part of his system which was called Ray No Play. And essentially, I was just blown away, kind of like, I mean, at first I just thought it was, kind of funny to kind of just make other teams jump off sides. But when I realized what kind of weapon that Ray No Play was, it's even though it's a simple play, it's a lot more of like a mental chess game with other teams. So I'm just basically going to go to the whiteboard and I'm just going to basically go over a couple of things like, first of all, what is Ray No Play, why I use it, and just some of the ways to effectively use Ray No Play in your double wing attack, specifically the double wing attack that that I obviously market. It's my offense that you see on this page. So, I don't use it as much as gun. It works kind of better in UC double wing, but I'll kind of just talk when we get on the whiteboard. I'll just talk and kind of work you guys through that. So again, I really appreciate all the activity on my channel. Everything's been going well. A lot of coaches reaching out to me, so I really appreciate all the new subscribers. And don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. Thanks a lot. Let's go to the whiteboard. Okay, we are back over at my whiteboard. Okay, so first of all, describing Ray No Play and how this works in my system. Again, it's a modular play call that fits in my system, and it just describes the motion. I use Ray and Lee motion. Ray motion is motion from the left wing back going in motion to the right. If I call Lee, my right wing back knows that he has to move in motion to the left. So it's a simple, just a simple only the motion call. So essentially, again, in my play calling structure, this play is just the motion. There is no play. So essentially, it tells everyone else that we're not running a play. So it's a really simple coach. It doesn't really take a lot of teaching time to get everyone to not, on our side, not jump off sides. A lot of the times I see teams that vary their cadence and they go on two, sometimes they go on three, and 9 times out of 10, you'll have your offensive lineman jumping off sides. So on a play call like this, my kids got really good at running this play specifically because there is no play. Like I told them, every time we run this play, there's no play. So when the quarterback says go, you're not to do anything because there's exactly no play. This is conditioned by a down, set, go cadence. So I'm just going to write my cadence. As we start the season, my kids are taught down, set, go by rule. So on they come out, they break the huddle, and they get in the ready stance, which is basically their elbows on their knees, eyes up in front of them. And the quarterback runs the line. Once everybody's set in formation, the quarterback calls down. When he calls down, everyone that's supposed to go in a three-point stance goes in a three-point stance, okay, to include my wings, the entire line. The center is already ready, but everybody's in a three-point stance. Now on set, that's when the motion starts. My three-back or whoever's deemed by the play call to move in motion starts his motion. And then on go, the ball is snapped. So the reason this works is because I never alter my cadence from a down, set, go, down, set, go, down, set, go. So
the way I get this play to work is because it works just because of repetition. So after, you know, the defense has seen down, set, go, and I'm running 34 power, you know, this kid goes in motion and gets the toss and runs this way. This kid goes in motion and gets the toss and runs this way. This kid goes in motion and gets the toss and runs this way. After the defense has seen it, that's how it's best used as an offensive weapon. Now, why do I use this play, or like, what are some of the reasons that I would use this play? Number one, a lot of times I use this play to erase lost yardage due to a penalty or a mistake. If my team comes to the line and, I mean, we miss a block and I get tackled in the backfield and I come out and it's second and 14, almost 90% of the time I will, right after that, I will run, number one, I'll try to correct the error, and then I will run Ray no play to attempt to get a free 5 yards back. Usually when the defense gets a stop and it's second and 14, usually they got their ears pinned back a little bit more for second down. So I find that Ray no play in a situation like that works great. Another reason that I use this play is versus blitzers or anyone that's trying to time up my snap count. So on this, on my whiteboard, I've put this defense out here. This is a defense I've seen, you know, with a TNT, a 5-3, but you got a rover moving around and you got backers up in the kind of threatening the A gaps, or maybe these kids are stepping in and they're jumping around and they're doing all kinds of movement. If I see that, I'll immediately, at some point in the drive, I'll come out with a Ray no play. Now, I do that for a couple reasons, because once you get hit with one Ray no play, like if this kid, this rover, is starting to kind of, as he sees this kid move in motion, he starts his run and just tries blitzing this gap. Once he gets caught once or twice, it has a huge effect on slowing the defense down. So it's a mental thing to use against the defense, in addition to racking up penalty yards. I mean, there's times that I've called this maybe 6 or 7 times in a game and literally got 35 free yards out of just using this play. So so a couple of things about how to effectively use Ray no play in a situation, you know, like something like this. Another thing I see with loaded fronts is that sometimes youth football players have a propensity, especially defensive linemen. You put some of these heavier kids out here, they usually sometimes they're looking at the ground. And if a lot of these kids are loaded in here and their eyes down and they're going by more sound, like the cadence of down, set, go, and I make sure that my quarterback is yelling down, set, go every time with volume and cadence the entire time. So if these kids are heads down and they're going by an audible signal of go, they'll jump off sides too. So I use it for a couple of reasons, and that's just, you know, a couple of reasons why I use it. Now, one of the ways to effectively use Ray no play is, I found out real quick, you have to have a plan B. So if they don't jump off sides, you have to do something. Now, however you decide to do that is really up to you. I found that running wedge after, you know, if they don't jump, is the best idea to you know, to kind of set that up. So real quickly, I'll kind of just show you one. It's a video from the intro video. I'll show you real quick. I'll just, you know, stop the whiteboard and just kind of show you a team that didn't jump off sides and what I mean by, you know, going on the second go. Okay, so as you saw there, that team didn't jump. So by rule, my kids know to just run wedge on the second go. So obviously you can't hear the cadence, you know, because the volume wasn't up in the game. But he just essentially, he calls down, set, go. If they jump and he doesn't see any penalty flags or the referee's blowing whistles, then he kind of resets for a second. And then on the second go, they just wedge. Now, one of the specialty things I kind of do is, because I always wedge from bowl, I just found that it was easier to wedge, because on the wedge, my quarterback always opens up to motion. So what I found out is easier for him to open up and for the fullback to just take the ball from him and just tuck into the wedge, like right here, as the wedge forms up. So I always bowl a line when I'm going to run Ray no play. So I'll usually call it like bowl, Ray no play, OK? okay? That just tells my fullback that he's going to be in the bull position to make it easier for the wedge. So that's one thing about having a plan B. You can, you know, you can create whatever plan B you want. Just make sure you have a plan B for if they do not jump. Now, one of the things about Ray No Plan using this thing effectively is I use this sparingly, but I, you know, I don't try to call this every single drive. I mean, it really depends on what the defense is doing, but I don't try to go crazy with it. So one thing I want you to understand is that I use, again, when I do say I use it sparingly, I also use it at high tension moments. And what I mean by that is like fourth and one. What I spoke about earlier is like after a like a big penalty, they tackle you in the backfield and all the defense is high-fiving and chest bumping. That right after that, I'll use it again because I consider that a high tension moment. Fourth and ones, short yardage on game drives, like you're trying to come back to win the game and you're down by 4 points and it's like, you know, third and two, I will come out with a Ray No play. And again, anytime you see timing of the snap count by the defense, I have caught so many people just, you know, trying to run blitz, you know, you see, you know, down and then your quarterback gets ready to call set and you see this kid take off. I will call, like, if that happens and he blows up the play right after that, I'll call Ray No play. Cause again, this play has a, almost like a demoralizing effect on the defense. They have to sit on their heels a little bit more. And for being a double wing team, again, my line is extremely recessed. So, you know, the ball is out here. Let's say this is the football. So nobody can really come. I mean, the line of scrimmage, their helmets can't cross this. So my kids are extremely recessed. So when I see stuff like this, I just tell my kids, just hold it down. Don't move. Don't anybody jump. There's no play. Okay. And I've caught so many teams just like trying to time up my snap counts or be real aggressive with blitzing and just kind of stemming and shifting before the snap. And I just don't allow it. I come out with Ray No Play. So I hope you guys got a lot of knowledge out of Ray No Play today and how I use it in my double wing attack. And again, if you want any more information on anything you've seen here, don't hesitate to contact me at westcoastload@yahoo.com. Have a great day. Bye.